America, the country is changing fundamentally, and it is changing overnight. Progressives and their friends in the government can't get enough of the union. And I saw this quote from former Labor Secretary Robert Reich, and I thought, you got to be kidding me. How does anybody believe it? Here it is. Unionization is not just good for workers and unions. Unionization is very, very important for the economy overall and would create broad benefits for the United States. If they did have higher wages and benefits, then they would have purchasing power they need to buy more of the goods and services that this economy produces. That would strengthen the economy overall. I took like 40 seconds just to think about that one, and I went, well, if unions are so great, wouldn't that mean then Detroit would be Disney World? Shouldn't that be the most prosperous place on earth? Here's Tim Phillips, president for Americans for Prosperity. Tim, help me out on this one.
Well, sadly, there's delusion going around, and he's drinking the water, clearly. When you look at the numbers, states that are non-unionized, where people have the freedom to choose whether to join a union or not, that's where prosperity is, and that's where job growth is. And it only makes sense, right?
Right.
When people have a chance to choose whether or not they're going to join a union over being forced, coerced into joining a union, prosperity results. Jobs are created. When you look at the numbers, they bear this very fact out.
Okay, those are the states that are the free states. Colorado just changed, right?
Yeah, 22 states are free states, 28 states are forced union states.
Okay.
And when you look at the numbers here, it's mind-boggling.
All right.
Flip to the next chart.
Go to the next chart. What are the numbers here? Do you have the numbers? Which numbers are you looking for?
We're looking for the GDP and the job growth, private job growth.
Okay, private sector.
When you look
growth.
At the increase in jobs, the right-to-work states are exploding. 39% job growth, 39% the union states, 29%. Yet unions are the ones that are supposed to be creating jobs, right? The reality does not bear that out. And then the growth is the most stunning thing. Growth is really just measurements of prosperity. Are jobs being created? Are people having a higher standard of living? When you look at those numbers, you see it's almost 2-1, or really is 2-1. In free states, right-to-work states, people succeed and grow and have jobs, and that's what we're talking about.
You can, I just finished a stage show. I did a one-man stage show and had to do it because it was here in New York. Had to do it with the union.
Right.
I actually had to pay somebody to stand behind somebody who wasn't union all day. I asked for water backstage.
Amazing.
I'm not kidding you. In Philadelphia, at the Kimmel Center, it cost me, I think it was $400 or $450 to put water backstage. I said, I'll just bring my own water. Couldn't do it. Now, how could you possibly tell me that that's good for the country?
Well, it's not. And when you look at population growth, people are voting with their feet. These right-to-work states where there's freedom, population is exploding there. They're beating more than 2-1 in population growth, the states that are forced union states. So people vote with their feet. When they have to use these silly rules you just mentioned just to get a job, they get out of there. They go to states where there's freedom.
Back in just a second with a little bit more.